Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. Kay here from At Home with Kay, and today I wanted to try my hand at using some jute string, some jute twine. You know, the kind that you get from Dollar Tree or Walmart. I'm actually going to be using the Walmart jute twine today. So what I have here first, I have these nesting boxes that I got from Dollar Tree, and I want to make a tiered tray. I like those tiered trays that look like wicker baskets, kind of, but I haven't been able to find one. I know they have them on Amazon. I'll probably end up getting one from there. But right now, I just decided to make one out of these nesting boxes. I wish these nesting boxes had been round, because I have certain shapes that I like, and I like round over square if I had to choose, you know. So, but I'm gonna use what I have. So I have this roll here, and I can't remember what it came from. It wasn't from paper towel or anything. It must have been from aluminum foil, because it was a little bit more sturdy. And I'm just gonna cut it so that I can use it as the pillar for my tier tray. I'm just sanding down where it was uneven from my cut, and then I'm gonna just see how it fits. And this is how it's gonna be set, and the smaller one is gonna be on top like that. And that's how it's gonna go. But what I'm gonna do first is I need to cover the boxes. I'm gonna cover with this jute rope, and then the tubes there, I'm gonna cover with the thinner one that I got from Dollar Tree. And that's gonna take a little bit of time because the jute rope is so thin. But you know, I just turned on a show and just started wrapping and gluing randomly as I went along, and I soon got it done. So today is Sunday. How is everyone doing today? I am doing quite well. The weekend is coming to a close, and it's back to Monday. Mondays are hard for us. I know it is, but I try to stay positive, you know, because, you know, I'm here, I'm alive. God has chosen to wake me up this morning, and I am thankful for that. So here we are. I completed wrapping my little pillars, and now it's time to start wrapping my nesting boxes. I was kind of contemplating, should I first paint them or something, but I'm not going to, you know. I'm just going to start wrapping them around with this jute rope I got from Walmart, and then when I get done, I will add antique wax to the inside and to the bottom, you know, to get it all a finished look. And I'm going to do that off camera, but I am going to show you as I wrap this around a couple times, and then I'll show you what it looks like when I'm all set. And this is actually a piece that I will use in my house, you know, in my home. I had gotten a little burnt out from crafting because I had made so many things that wasn't really my style, and I had accumulated all this stuff. So from now on, that's what my plan is, and I hope that's okay, but you know, for me it's okay. So I added the antique wax to the bottom and the inside of these boxes, and now I'm just gonna add my pillars to put my tier tray together. And I'm adding the longer one, and then I'm gonna add the smaller one. And what I mean is, I had accumulated tubs and tubs and rubber tubs of crafts that I didn't use, you know, and it had just accumulated over the years. And when I moved, I actually had to get rid of a lot of it. So I don't want to do that again. I just want to make things that are my style, that I like, and that I think you would like as my subscribers as well, and just use them in my home. And I think that's a wiser decision for me financially and everything. So I'm just adding a little hot glue here, and then I'm going to add the smaller nesting box on top. And then we have our three-tiered tray. Wow, and now that I look on it at it on camera, it looks like a cat scratching post. All right, so now let's make some items to put on our tier tray. I got these wooden pumpkins from Dollar Tree. The thinner one I've had in my stash for a while. This one I picked up the other day. And I'm going to add some antique wax on top, and then I'm gonna do that on both of them. Just a little antique wax, then wipe it off with a paper towel. Okay, so next I'm gonna take some of this, this vine twine from Dollar Tree with the buds on it. And I'm just gonna make some little twirls with it. I wrapped it around my glue stick just to get something to wrap it to. And I'm going to just hot glue those onto my pumpkin. Thank you. All right, so next, you guys know these wooden roses that you get from Dollar Tree. They were out, you know, some seasons ago, but I had some still in my stash, so I got them out, and I'm gonna use these thin dowels that I also picked up from Dollar Tree or Walmart, can't remember, and I'm just gonna make some stems for my plants, for my roses, and I'm going to hot glue them onto the rose. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a nice napkin that I got. I think I got it from May, from Craft Away with May a couple years ago. She sent me some napkins, and I am going to use this napkin to make my roses just look a little bit more fancy, you know, instead of just them being wood. Now I'm gonna add some Mod Podge. Take the Mod Podge and put it all around, because I'm gonna start in the inside of the rose, adding the little napkin pieces. And this is the napkin, and I think it's really pretty, but I cut it in strips. And then later on, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna realize that the strips were a little bit too long, so then I just cut them in little tiny squares, and that was easier to work with the Mod Podge. But I'm just placing the Mod Podge in there and just placing it on the napkin. And here we are. I cut my little pieces in strips now, and I'm just gonna use that. It was a lot easier with the napkin cut in strips rather than those long, cut in little squares rather than those long pieces. So that's what I'm doing here. And then I'm just gonna show you how I did the stem, and then I'll show you all these completed at the end of the video. So next, I got these mushrooms from Hobby Lobby around Valentine's Day, and I've never used them, so I decided to make just like a little, some little mushrooms and paint them different colors. And I have that wood round, that little round piece of wood, that's gonna be the pedestal that I'm gonna place my mushrooms on. So I sanded down my little round with my sanding block just to get, you know, some of the paint off. And then I'm going to use this orange, I'm going to use pink, and then I have this tan color, and that's what color the mushrooms are going to be. And then I'm going to make the spots on my mushroom, I'm just going to use brown. And here's my brown for my spots. I'm just gonna take my paintbrush and dip it in there and just randomly place some spots on top of my mushrooms. And now I'm gonna hot glue. I put a lot of hot glue on these, and I am going to just hot glue them to this round. And I'm just gonna, you know, make them touch because it's not really enough space for them to be spread out. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a little bit of that grape, those vines with the buds on it. And I will show you what this looks like all completed at the end of the video. And here we are at the end of the video. So this is what my little tear tray turned out like. I have my mushrooms here at the top, and I put the grapevine, the little vine around it. I keep calling it grapevine. I don't know what to call it. And I placed the flowers just behind, just so, don't they look kind of antique, these little flowers? I really like them. And then it's not very full, a full tear tray. It's just got a few items in each little tray, which I like. I think this is really cute, and I can use it for other things after fall is over. And let me know what you guys think. Thank you so much for clicking on my video today. Don't forget to like and comment and subscribe if you're not already a subscriber. I appreciate each and every one of you, and let me know what you all think about this little tear tray. And remember to always be the sunshine.